Good morning, students. In our previous session, we have done crime report, which is a form of newspaper report. Now we'll learn how to write an FIR. By the end of this video, you will be able to know what is an FIR, how is it lodged and by whom is it lodged, what are the necessary details required for the FIR and important vocabulary to be used in FIR. FIR refers to First Information Report. So what is First Information Report? FIR is a written document prepared by the police when they receive information about any offence. Offence, children, means any crime that has taken place. It is a report of information that reaches the police first in point of time, and that is why it is called the First Information Report. That means whenever any theft, kidnapping, snatching or any other crime occurs, the first information report is lodged to the police. And this first information report is called an FIR. Now children, you are to remember one thing, that this FIR is lodged by either the victim himself or by anyone else. And this report is written in first person active voice. So it is generally a complaint lodged by the police, by the victim, that means a sufferer, or by someone else on his behalf. Anyone can report the offense either orally or in writing to the police. But you are to remember that it has to be written in first person pronoun along with active voice. An FIR is a very important document as it sets the process of criminal justice in motion. That means the police will come in the action when an FIR is lodged. It is only after the FIR is registered the police station that the police takes up the investigation of the case. So only after an FIR is lodged the police will start up its inquiry. Let us first of all discuss the format of the FIR. We'll write down form number 24.5, and in bracket you have to write down 1. This is the format, children, and it has to be written in the center of the page. After this, in the next line, in center, you will write down first information report. All the alphabets have to be capital here. In the next line, you will write down first information of cognizable crime reported under section 154 Criminal Procedure Code. Now what is cognizable crime? Cognizable means capable of being known, right? So this is the format. Form number 24.51, first information report, first information of a cognizable crime reported under section 154 Criminal Procedure Code. These letters written in red are the meaning which is not to be written. This is for your understanding. After this, in the next line, you will write down the police station, nearby police station, the district where the crime has occurred, and the number of the FIR. It can be any random number. Then you will talk about date and hour of occurrence. When did the crime occur? Date and hour when reported. When did you report it in the police station? Name and residence of the informer and the complainant. It can be the victim himself or it can be anyone else on his behalf. Brief description of offense. That means which crime has occurred and what property is carried off. That means if any property is carried off, you will give the details. Place of occurrence and distance and direction from the police station. Name and address of the criminal or suspect. In some cases, name of the suspect is unknown. You do not know who has done that crime. So you won't give the name and address. But if you know or you suspect somebody, you will have to give the name and address of that person. Then you will give your signature, name and address. Your, because you are the complainant. And at last, you will write down the phone number. So this is the format of the FIR, that is our first information report. Now let us start with the report writing. Here, lodge an FIR at the nearest police station for a burglary that has taken place in your house while you were out of the city to attend a wedding. So you have been given when has this crime occurred. You were out of the city to attend a wedding. The outline for this is, I had gone to attend a wedding, all the members accompanying me. Domestic help stayed back in house. Who is domestic help, children? It is any servant. Returned home past midnight. Motorcycle DL2H5293 Bajaj Pulsar missing. You are to give the details if the property is missing. I told you already. Whole house is ransacked. Ransacked, what is ransacked, children? Ransacked is when the goods are stolen and property is destroyed. The burglars decamped with rupees 50,000 cash. What is the meaning of decamped, children? It means running away. So the burglars decamped with rupees 50,000 cash, jewelry worth rupees 1 lakh, a CD player and a motorcycle. Servant is also missing. So he becomes the suspect here. Found a phone diary with some phone numbers. A neighbor informed that he had seen the servant riding pillion. What do you mean by riding pillion? That means he was not driving the vehicle. It was somebody else and he was sitting behind that person. So a person who sits behind is a pillion rider. Carrying bulky knapsacks. Now let us start with the FIR, children. The format, form number 24.51. First information report. First information of a cognizable crime reported under section 154 Criminal Procedure Code. Then you will write down the name of the police station. Here I have written civil lines. Which district? Amritsar. Number of FIR? I have written 121. You may write any other number as well. Now, as I had already told you, it has to be written in first person active voice. And that is our first point. What is it, children? Name and residence of informer and complainant. So I, Sunil Gupta, son of Mr. Abhay Gupta, resident of 23 Civil Lines, Amritsar, lodge a complaint about a burglary in my house. On the evening of 21st January, when I had gone to attend a wedding in Gurugram. So date and hour of occurrence, we have told already. Name and residence of the informer also is written. All the members of my family were accompanying me and only a domestic help. Who is domestic help? Servant. Ram Swaroop stayed back in the house. As we returned home past midnight, my son's motorcycle DL2H5293 Bajaj Pulsar, which he had parked near the gate, was missing. So we are giving the brief description of the offense and what property is carried off in this paragraph. See again. So as we returned home past midnight, my son's motorcycle DL2H5293 Bajaj Pulsar, which he had parked near the gate, was missing. To our utter shock, we noticed that the whole house had been ransacked. The burglars had decamped, that is ran away, with rupees 50,000 cash, my wife's jewelry worth rupees 1 lakh, a CD player and my son's motorcycle. So what does this paragraph tell you? It tells us about the brief description of the offense and the property carried off. Our servant Ram Swaroop was also missing. This is how he becomes the suspect. So our servant Ram Swaroop was also missing. He surely seems to be involved in the case, as a few silver antiques from an old trunk in my mother's room are missing, about which only an insider would know. So here, who was alone in the house? It was Ram Swaroop. And he was also the insider who would know about the antiques kept in the old trunk. So he becomes the suspect. In Ram Swaroop's room, we have found a phone diary with some phone numbers which I submit herewith, as it might prove to be of some help in your investigation. What is investigation, children? Official and systematic inquiry. Now, as Ram Swarup was living in this house only, so whatever evidences they have found against Ram Swarup, that is phone numbers with a diary with some phone numbers, they are going to submit it to the police. Our neighbor, Mr. Karan Pal, later informed us that he had seen Ram Swarup riding pillion. What is riding pillion, children? Sitting behind the rider. With a man of average height on my son's motorcycle around 9 p.m. on the outer road. So it is the same bike that has been stolen, right? He was wearing a red sweater and the other man was wearing a brown leather jacket. They were both carrying bulky means heavy, knapsacks. What are knapsacks? A bag carried over the shoulders. So this is an eyewitness, a neighbor, Mr. Karan Pal, who had seen Ram Swarup, who was riding pillion on the same bike which had been stolen along with some other person. And he was carrying bulky knapsack. That also makes him a suspect in this case. Now he has given all the details about the person he suspects and also about the details of what things have been missing, right? So I should be obliged if you would investigate the matter and retrieve my lost possessions. So this paragraph is being addressed to the police. So the person who is the complainant says that he would be obliged if the police investigates and brings back his lost possessions. I should be obliged if you keep me informed of the details of the proceedings in the case. At this, we will end our FIR with the name of the complainant, that is Sunil Gupta. His address, that is 23 Civil Lines, District Amritsar, and his mobile number 9876543210. Now let us discuss about some important vocabulary which you can write in your FIRs. So whenever a complaint is made to police, it is called as lodged a complaint. We do not use the word made, we use the word lodged. You may use the term nab the culprit in place of catch the culprit. Apart from jewelry, cash, garments, kitchen products and upholstery may also be added in stolen articles. Goods are usually strewn all over when such thefts occur. Strewn over means the things are untidily placed. You may also use the word flabbergasted in place of shocked. So you may say, I was flabbergasted when I entered my house. You may also use the phrase, the door was ajar, which means the door was open. Now let us see the homework, children. A thief has snatched your handbag away on the road. Lodge an FIR with the local police station giving details of the incident in not more than 300 words. Remember, children, it is not an essay, it is a report writing. So you are to give the factual details. You may use the following guidelines. On way to college for the farewell party, walking alone, name of the road, date and place of occurrence, a youngster came from behind on bike, snatched away the handbag, disappeared in 5 minutes, description of the bike, number plate went unnoticed in confusion, appearance of the youngster, the list of significant articles in purse, rupees 700 plus a mobile phone, a digital camera, description of the handbag. You may give other necessary details as well. Now in this case, children, we do not know who the suspect can be or who is the person who has stolen. So you do not need to give any name of the suspect. Thank you.